Hey guys! Welcome back to my channel. Today I decided to film a little mukbang Q&A moment. I haven't done one of these in a long ass time. I also have no idea where I'm going. Hold on, please. I feel like I always used to just sit in my car and eat and chat with you guys, and it was always just like fun, and I feel like I just want to talk to you guys. I just want to chat. I want to eat my lunch with you. So that's what we're going to do. I had you guys ask me some questions on Instagram, and I'm just going to be answering them while I eat my lunch. We're going to pick it up right now. I ordered Takaya. I don't know like if they have Takaya anywhere other than LA, because I never had it until I moved here. It is so good. It's basically just like healthy Chipotle. You guys know like I love Chipotle so much, but every time that I eat it, TMI, I have like next day. That's too gross. I think that's too gross to say on the internet. I don't think I can say that. But basically my stomach really does not feel the best the day after eating Chipotle. And then I discovered a Takaya, and it literally is like very similar to Chipotle, except I do not have a stomach ache the day after eating it. So it is really just the best thing I've ever discovered. I'm addicted to it, like genuinely addicted. I'm gonna pick it up and then we're going to park and eat. I'm pretty pumped about it, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, I'm gonna go to Takaya, pick up my food, and then I'll be back. Ciao. Got it. I feel like this lighting is really bad. Should I move? Be honest, I think I should. I'm gonna. Okay. And this is the best we're gonna do when it comes to lighting. I also kind of have to pee, so we're starting off on a terrible note. The downfall of where I'm parked right now is that anyone in the McDonald's line can see me, which is kind of embarrassing, but I also have learned to not give a fuck. So what I get from Takaya is the street corn bowl. Instead of the turkey, I get chicken tinga. That's what it looks like. It's so good. It's like genuinely amazing. If anyone can see me right now, I'm just like posing with the bowl. Okay. Oh my god, there's people in the car next to me. Mortified. Mortified. Mortified is the word. Okay. I also get this Chipotle crema stuff. Mix this puppy up. Man, it is so good. Hits the spot every time. I need a couple of bites before I start chatting because bitch is hungry. I also got some chippies. Just like Chipotle, I scoop up the bowl with the chip. Just unreal. Truly, there's a lot going on in this parking lot. It's giving me anxiety. Unpopular opinion, or a popular opinion, I'm not really sure, tell me. But I think it's so weird when somebody can just like get in their car and instantly start driving. Like I need to get myself situated before the car moves. I need to put on my favorite song. I need to just situate myself. Some people could really just hop in and start going. It's really weird to me. First question, we're gonna start off easy. If you were to move anywhere else besides Cali and New York, where would it be? I would love to live in Europe for like 6 months to a year. That would be so fun. Actually, maybe that's a little long. I don't know how long I would like to do it for, but I would love to live in Europe for a period of time. Probably Italy. I feel like I would just thrive. When it comes to in the US, I don't really think that there's anywhere else besides New York or California that I would like to live in. Like maybe New Jersey, because that's close to New York. There's nowhere else I could think of. Like any city, I guess. Arizona is pretty nice. I feel like I would think about Arizona. Like I haven't been to Miami enough, but I feel like Miami could be a vibe for a while. We will see where life shall take me. People also always ask me like how long I think I'll live in LA for, where I think that I'll like live next, blah, blah, blah. And I really just don't know. Like I don't have a plan of like how long I'll be living here or where I wanna go next. Like I just don't know. I feel like I live life very day by day. I would love to be bi-coastal more than anything. I think that would be amazing. I feel like if an opportunity were to come up to make me live somewhere else, I wouldn't say no. I would go anywhere. I'm like literally down for anything. For the next like 2 years, I'm definitely probably gonna be living in LA. Who knows after that though. Talking to anyone? I am single right now. That's that on that. I definitely like talk to boys, obviously, but I've come to the realization that I am just not ready for a relationship at this point in my life. I just am so good on my own right now, and I feel very independent, and I'm just very focused on like my goals and what I want to do with my life. I like being alone right now. That's the vibe. I do not want a boyfriend at all right now. I made a TikTok saying that I hooked up with my celebrity crush. And a lot of people are asking who said celebrity was. First of all, I will never name names of anybody with any sort of following that I hook up with. That is just not my thing. Also, it's like, these are regular people. I would never want somebody going online and talking about me when I've had like personal encounters with them. Like, I don't know, if somebody is like vulnerable enough with you to like tell you things about them and like be with you in a certain way, I just think it's so disrespectful to like go on the internet after and be like, guess who I will not do that. Like, no matter how dirty this man did me, I will not expose him. I guess I can just leave the rest to your imagination. I also really hope he didn't see that TikTok or sees this, because he definitely did not know that I had a crush on him before. Actually, no, he probably figured that I had a crush on him before. If you do happen to be watching this, go fuck yourself. Anyway, would you ever get plastic surgery? Personally, I wouldn't. Actually, if somebody came to me and offered to pay for a nose job, I would probably take it, just because why not? I also don't hate my nose. I just could like it more. You know what I mean? The most I would do is like filler and like Botox maybe if I got wrinkles one day. But no, plastic surgery, I honestly just like don't want to change anything about myself enough to go through that kind of pain. I feel like that shit probably hurts so bad. Nothing against plastic surgery, obviously. Like, if you could do something to make you more confident, do it. Like, I am such a pro plastic surgery person. I just personally don't want to get any plastic surgery for myself. Who knows if that could also change one day? You never know. But as of right now, no. If your man texted another woman, is that cheating? I think that it depends on what they were texting about. Like, if he was saying some sus things, like being all flirty and shit, yeah, that's cheating. But if it's just like one of his friends that he's just like having a regular normal conversation with, no, it's not cheating. But if he's texting some suspicious woman and flirting with her, break up with him. I have to pee so bad.
I'm gonna explode.
Would you ever move back to New York? Yes. I definitely would move back to New York. I feel like raising a family on the East Coast is definitely ideal. I would love to move back to New York eventually. Also, like I said, one of my goals is to be bicoastal. If you could switch labs with any one of your friends, who would it be and why? Whenever Miss Emma Top is traveling the world, I want to be that bitch. So me and Emma could switch lives while she's traveling the world. While she's at school, maybe not, because I'm not trying to do all that work. But when she's being Miss freaking worldwide, yeah. Favorite TV show right now? Recently, I've been rewatching Sex and the City. I have watched Sex and the City literally 10 times already. It's my all-time favorite show, probably. That, 90210, One Tree Hill, Gossip Girl. I can't think of anything else right now, but those are like my top favorite shows. What do you look for in a guy? What do I look for in a guy? At this point, I don't even know. I feel like what I'm physically attracted to, definitely guys with like tattoos, taller guys, which is very hypocritical because I'm short as fuck. I tend to like dark hair, dark features more often.
I like him tall, dark, and handsome, baby.
That's my physical type. I don't know, actually. I feel like most of the guys that I've talked to look different. But there are definitely a few that I'm like way more physically attracted to, but I don't limit myself to that when it comes to talking to guys. Like, if I like put a picture of all the different guys I've talked to next to each other, everyone would be like, Amanda, you have no type at all. Because honestly, like, personality for me is everything. I know everyone says that, but it really, really is. Like, I like somebody that has drive, passions, hard worker, funny. If you're not making me laugh, someone who's honest, loyal, nice. Basically the perfect man. Thank you. Can I have him? My standards are so high. I'm so picky. One thing happens and I'm turned off for the rest of eternity. So last sneaky link. I honestly don't really have sneaky links at all. Like, I don't have a sneaky link. What is your zodiac chart? I am a Scorpio sun, Libra moon, and Sagittarius rising. Broke up with my boyfriend of almost 5 years. Tips on being okay with being alone. First of all, I love you. I hope that you're doing okay. 5 years is a long time to be with somebody. I think like just do random things that you would have typically done with your boyfriend and start doing them by yourself. The other day I took myself on a date, which I actually filmed, so go watch that video if you have not. But yeah, I took myself on a little picnic date to Malibu and it was so nice. It was like therapeutic. I felt so independent. Like I did something for myself that like normally you would do with a guy, you know, but you can do those things for yourself. Yeah, don't push yourself too hard. Also, you obviously need to feel things and like process the emotions because you're gonna be upset after being with someone for 5 years and then breaking up. So definitely let yourself feel those things. But I would say just little by little, start doing random little things alone that you typically wouldn't. After a while, it just feels normal. Like right now, I swear I've become so independent that being with somebody is like difficult for me. And that's like so weird and never thought that would really happen to me, but it did and it's kind of crazy. So, but yeah, I wish you the best of luck. I love you. My DMs are always open and I hope that you are doing okay. Also, I'm so sorry. I keep looking in the fucking viewfinder. Whenever I'm editing my videos, I just look at the viewfinder the entire time. It's so annoying. To stop. What is the messiest situation you've gotten in? One time, two best friends made me decide between them and then they stopped being friends because I did indeed choose one. That was messy. That was pretty messy. Oops. Has your body count changed since moving? It has. It hasn't changed drastically, but I've had like a few different things with guys since moving here. So yes, it has. What is something you're proud of? I think that I'm just really proud that I was able to move across the country by myself at 21, or at 20, actually. That's just so crazy to me. I think about it sometimes and I'm like, how am I doing? Like, I don't know. It's obviously just such a big change and to do it alone is definitely a lot. And I'm just so, so, so proud of myself that I was able to do it. There definitely were a ton of ups and downs along the way, but I'm so happy with my decision and I'm freaking proud of myself. Do you ever have regrets of moving to California? I don't ever regret anything in life and I love living here. Like I'm so happy with my decision, but sometimes I definitely think about it and I'm like, maybe I should have like gotten an apartment first, like somewhere near home, and then eventually more further down the line came out here. I've definitely had those thoughts here and there, but overall like I'm really happy with my decision and I love living here so much, so I don't regret it, but I've definitely like questioned it. Are you an introvert or an extrovert? I think that I am an introverted extrovert. Like I definitely am good in social situations. I like hanging out with friends a lot. I love all of that. But I also like need my alone time to recharge. So yeah, I'm definitely a mix of both. Are the men worse in New York or LA? I think men just suck like no matter where you go, to be honest. All right, I think that that's gonna wrap up this video. I feel like I've answered a ton of questions and I am done with my food. So I think I'm gonna go. I also have had to pee the entire time that I've been filming this. I'm struggling. I really enjoyed just sitting down and chatting with you guys today. I wanna do this more often. I feel like it's just fun, chill vibes. Let me know if you liked this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I love you all to the moon and back and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye.